Do I know any jokes? Hey, Ted, did I tell you the story of, I put my phone down on the bar. So I put the phone down, it's got the Nina case. He goes, you know, that case gets is a conversation piece, you know? So I put it down, he goes, that's funny. I was like, what's funny about it? And he's like, your phone case, it's funny. I said, do you know who that is? And he was like, is that Aphrodite? And I was like, nope, that's Nina Simone. And he said, Nina Simone, is that a designer? There are no musicians in my family. You know, my grandma played the accordion and the organ. I mean, people dabbled. My dad can play a couple songs on the banjo, you know. My parents brought me up on a strict diet that there is no music after 1975, you know? So I grew up on their records, their whole record collection, and I just ate through it. Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young, Joni Mitchell, Joan Baez, Bob Dylan, Neil Young, and Aretha, and that whole, you know, Atlantic thing, the whole, I mean, just, and they, the Big Chill soundtrack, essentially. If you feel you wanna kiss me, don't be afraid, I don't mind. All you got to do is snap your little fingers, and I'll come running, I ain't lying. I had a job in high school where I went around to restaurants. I had a list of like 200 songs, and I would put it on people's table at a restaurant and sing a cappella for money. Someday when I'm awfully low and the world is cold. And most restaurants were like, no thanks, you're 14. There's something about soul music that I've always connected with. You know? Aretha, Ava Cassidy, Nina, Chaka. Oh, I love Sade. Love Sade. Nobody sounds like her. Nobody makes the exact music she makes. She doesn't try to be everything. She doesn't try to be every singer and sing every note. I mean, Nina teaches you a lot, speaking of, because she like Sade, like, doesn't have all the melismas and all the riffs and all the, you know. So you may not know the words to a song, and you listen to it like a Nina recording and you're like, oh, those are the words, because there's not a bunch of extra stuff, you know? Kim Burrell, you know, gospel singer, and all three of those women, and, you know, play the piano. I wish I'd stick with piano, because there's something different about the way you, I mean, you know, the musicality of those women is like so far out. It's because they're, Glasper pointed that out to me. He was like, you know, all the women you love play the piano, and you need to play the piano. There's this far out recording Aretha does of, speaking of melding like soul and musical theater, this tune, musical theater tune, that she turned into an Aretha tune, you know? And she sits down at the piano and she's like, the way she phrases, like, I wanna be with you. Like the way she just sets it down. I wanna be with you. Like the way she plays the chords is so tender. Like you feel like a voyeur. There's a well of need in I moved to New York City when I was 18 years old. I felt a little bit like the black sheep of Juilliard, at least for the music department. Maybe a lot of people feel that way, but I felt like I was alone in that. I felt like I wasn't very good. I'm not a very good opera singer. Opera is not my gift, language is not my gift. But then I begged to go there, and I worked so hard to get there, and my gosh, everybody bent over backwards to make it so that I could be there, you know? I would never really tell anybody, like, that I was unhappy there and that it was hard and that I spent every voice lesson crying, really. That's the MO at Juilliard is, and probably other conservatories, but at Juilliard, is to break you down and build you back up, you know? And, I mean, frankly, I think everyone should have to go through an equivalent of it. I think about some of the things they said every single day, you know? And I think about some of the really valuable things all the time. I had graduated well after I'd graduated college. I had all my uni cards, I had an agent, I was auditioning for this, that, and the other, and I just hit a patch where I just couldn't get any work. Mr. Gordy was gonna be coming into town. He was casting for a workshop version of his new musical about his life. I got a breakdown from my agent, and I remember the breakdown said, I'm paraphrasing a little, but it basically said, needs to look like Doris Day and sound like Tina Marie. And I remember looking at that and I was like, oh, if I don't get this job, I quit. Like, I'm done. If I don't get this job, I am useless. From the minute I met Mr. Gordy, we were pals. You know, we were simpatico. And he just took a liking to me. He thought I was funny and he thought I was good. He wanted to find other things for me. I was just very humbled by his love. I have been from day one. Goes kind of like an A side, B side. The first half has electronic elements, some synths, synth drums, programming, and then the last half of the album has no programming at all. So it goes like from most modern to most old school, you know? And I'm just so excited that I got to make a record the way I made it. Real ingredients. We tracked it live, you know, I did all the backgrounds myself. We didn't tune a single friggin' note. Like, I wanted to make a record that was classic, that was built with the same ingredients that I grew up admiring and listening to, you know? We spent about a year trying the shit out live, you know? Trying these songs live in front of an audience, and an audience will tell you if your stuff is wrapped tight. An audience will tell you if your stuff is good. And that, I'm old school, you know? So I don't wanna just go invent something in a studio and not feel what, like, human beings feel about it. And you don't want people to say, oh, that's a nice record that she wrote about her life. You want people to say, that's about me. Because the best songs are songs where we say, that's just like my life. Oh my gosh. I look for songs that do that for me, you know? My favorite song is Say the Words. I wanted to write a song that I felt like Aretha would want. I wanted, like, my Ain't No Way. I wanted a big, meaty, classic 6'8" and steak. And all the things that you said to me, there's still one thing that I'm missing. No more long goodbyes, don't apologize. When you're singing something that is maybe hurts to sing every single time, like, that forces you to be real. Open your heart and just let me see that there ain't no place for me. And there are songs that are angry and songs that are sad, and I have to always keep that little piece that feels hurt accessible. I always have to keep a little pocket of that for myself. Best soul singing, whether it's in R&B or the blues, I mean, it's all roots of the blues. It all goes back to, like, a wail, you know? It all goes back to, there can be happy blues, but it all goes back to, like, a longing, a desperation, a wailing, you know, crying out. That's the roots of all of it. Everything that we now know is, like, riffing, you know? That was just some variation on, like, wailing, bigger, louder, longer, harder, you know? It's not for nothing, and it's not for play. My name is Morgan James, and I don't look like a soul singer, but I am a soul singer. But are you-